I graduated last year from St. Cloud State with a 3.18 GPA of low B average. I graduated from Morris Area High School 7 years ago with a 2.6 GPA, a straight C average. May is Mental Health Awareness Month. And last week, I was diagnosed with attention deficit disorder, or ADD. I was told that those with ADD often don't fare well in high school and usually don't enter a four-year university. If they do study at a four-year school, they tend not to graduate. And if they do graduate, only 3% of those with ADD enter and finish grad school. But it is possible. I had faith in myself that I could get this far. My parents, teachers, and mentors have faith in me, and I rely on that faith to keep me going. With this recent diagnosis, I can label my struggles and rely on the support of others. The psalmist writes today, "Therefore my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. My body also rests secure." I am secure in my faith, in the faith of others, and the support we all share. We all need support. So here I am. Here I am in front of you, against all odds that were presented me all but a week ago. For the longest time, I thought it would take me the longest time to get here. For so long, I've been saying, I'm on my way to seminary, and I have X number of years left before I can get there. Well, now I'm saying, yes, I'm in seminary, but I have X number of years left before I can have my own call. In 2 weeks, that number decreases by one. I'm getting there, and I have to do Thomas's due diligence and take my time. I have to make sure. This year has been a year of making sure. I've known for a few years that this is where I've needed to be. I've needed to be in seminary, but this year, it's been a process of making sure, of looking at Christ's hands and feet at Luther Seminary. I needed to come and see, just to make sure. Seminary and ministry are elements of life that need to be experienced before you can know for sure that one can do this for the rest of their foreseeable future. Sure, blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe, but I would add that those who come and see are also blessed. Ever since Martin Luther was able to mass-produce the Bible in the common tongue with the help of the Gutenberg Press, we've been able to come and see for ourselves in the text. We've been able to look upon Christ's hands and feet for ourselves. There are times when we can't afford to think. When life presents us with limited options, we shoot from the hip with the option we think is best. We make a leap of faith that everything will work out. There's no room for Thomas in these situations. Or is there? Thomas was utilizing his faith when he outstretched his hands and felt Christ's wounds. There will be times when we need to feel the wounds, and that's okay. We need to experience what others have experienced. For that, as the confirmation kids learned on Wednesday, is community. Thomas was a part of that community of the disciples, and he needed to reconnect with this community. It was Thomas's faith that propelled him to ask to see Christ's wounds, not his lack of faith. It all comes down to faith. Faith is what drove the disciples to the upper room. They may have been frightened, but their faith in Christ held them together in this community. It was faith that led Thomas to the upper room. It was faith that drove Thomas to ask what to see the risen Christ's hands and feet. I have faith that Jesus Christ died and rose again for my salvation from sin. Does it make me any less of a Christian if I sin boldly now and then? Martin Luther famously suggested that we sin boldly, saying, "Be a sinner and let your sins be strong, but let your trust in Christ be stronger And rejoice in Christ, who is the victor over sin, death, and the world. We will commit sins while we are here, for this life is not a place where justice resides. We, however, are looking forward to a new heaven and a new earth, where justice will reign. For that is the promise of Easter, that our risen Christ died on the cross for our sins, and we rose again on the third day. We are saved by God's grace through our faith. We may need to look upon the wounds of Christ now and then, but we are certainly blessed if we don't. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Look upon the wounds of your risen Christ and belong to this community we call Christianity. For we are defined as Christians because of this Easter miracle. Jews and Muslims believe that Jesus lived, taught, preached, and died. It is Jesus' resurrection on the third day that separates us from the other two Abrahamic faiths, but unites us as Christians. For there are many dividing lines that are drawn between Christian denominations, but this Easter miracle unites us all. So look upon the wounds of your risen Savior. Have that communal experience that Thomas was looking for, and live in the splendor of God's grace, love, and mercy. I leave you with the end of John's Gospel. But there are also many other things that Jesus did. If every one of them were written down, I suppose that the world itself could not contain the books that would be written. Christ is risen.
He is risen.
Hallelujah!